Hi, thanks for tuning in on our cleaning video. Today I'm going to polish this carriage of the Mercedes, and after that I'm going to wax it. I already did a bit, and now I'm going to focus on this area over here. Now you can use any polishing product you like, whatever is your preference. I'm going to use this stuff, because that's what I came across, and it works, which is not completely unimportant. I'm going to use just some flannel. This is a cut-up pyjama of one of my kids. They outgrew it. Don't worry, I did not destroy one of their favorite pyjamas. I might not be the best dad there is, but I'm also not a truly horrible dad. I use this stuff because it gives me the best results. Microfiber gave me some swirls last time I used it with this product, so that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna gently rub it all over this. Let it do its thing. This product is not allowed to dry up, so when I'm done with this, see, stuff is coming off. Then I need a nice clean rag to make sure I get every bit of product that's still on there, and at the same time polish this thing nice and shiny so I get a nice black mirror. Still need to do some extra work over here. That's looking a lot better. Now I just need to do everything else, and after that I'm gonna start waxing this thing. As I was continuing, I thought of some stuff I forgot to mention, and I also did the bottom half of this paper table. Now you can see where I stopped, and I hope you can see the massive difference. Now you see a dull reflection, and over there it's all bright as a black mirror. One thing I forgot to mention was stay away from those decals, because you can start eating them. And something you will notice when you are working on these is that you get this brown stuff coming off. That's probably some old shellac that's on top of this thing. I'm not removing it entirely, I'm just polishing all the cracks and creases out of it. Since you are watching this bit, I'll do this section next to the Mercedes as well. So you can see the difference when I'm done with it. Yes, this would go a lot easier if this plate was dismounted, but unfortunately that screw absolutely did not want to give way. Yeah, I'm doing this on this machine now. As you can see, stuff is coming off. Right, let's wipe away the product. Why do I want to get everything shiny? Well, one, looks pretty. Two, smooth stuff is more difficult to deteriorate because the stuff can't stick as easily to it. Let's do that light test again, shall we? You can see I missed a spot over here. You can also see where I stopped rubbing. Let's write like this. Here you see some dull stuff, and over here it's all black mirror. Yeah. I'm gonna continue working on this one. Still have a lot of black paint all around to clean. Of course, since I want to get the maximum black mirror effect that I can get, I also want to go between those letters. I already did between yes, here between D and the E you can see a little bit of dullness, same between the E and the D, the C is already done. So what I'm gonna do is use a little bit of product on a Q-tip, wipe away excess. Then very gently in between the letters. I'm not gonna get everything. It's not gonna be super shiny in between the letters, but it's gonna be at least better than what it is now. Clean rag, very gently. Don't want to put too much pressure on those letters. There we go. That's how you go in between those decals. Right, now this entire thing has been polished. Now I'm gonna apply some wax. Why applying wax? Because it adds protective layer on the entire machine. So we can enjoy this thing for years and years to come. Normally for more modern machines I use a Carnauba based wax, but for an old machine like this I feel like I'm just someone who takes care of it for some time and until I pass it on, until I pass on. So therefore I want everything I did to this thing to be as reversible as possible, so I'm gonna use Renaissance wax. Fun product. Smells a bit like, well, doesn't smell as nice as Carnauba wax. Carnauba wax smells like coconuts, this well. Yeah, it has a pungent smell. More like paint in it, if you ask me. Just again, soft cloth, rub it over it. And then just apply the wax. Rub it in gently. Like that. And then you wait until it dries and hazes over, and then you go over to the soft cloth. I'm gonna cut out the piece where it's drying and let you guys see what happens when I remove the wax. Well, it's all rubbed in now. Wait a bit to make sure it all gets a bit duller and dries a bit. And now it's time to grab your softest cloth and just rub it all off. And there you go. Nicely waxed, protected. And good for another few ages. Of course, if you want, you can always do some more layers of wax. But I don't know if I'm gonna do that. Maybe I will, but that's not for this video. So, all that's left for me to do is clean this thing. Make it shiny again. Alright, so cleansing and polishing later. I have now one very shiny black mirror. All I need to do now is the same procedure to the rest of the typewriter. So, I still have some work to do. Right, bye bye.